Sever's disease, also known as calcaneal apophysitis. The bones of children and adolescents possess a special area where the bone is growing, located near the ends of bones, called the growth plate. The growth plate in the back of the heel serves as the attachment point for the Achilles tendon, the strong band of tissue that connects the calf muscles at the back of the leg to the heel bone. Also called calcaneal apophysitis, Sever's disease is actually an injury, not a disease. It is caused by repetitive stress on the growth plate at the site where the Achilles tendon pulls on the back of the heel. The growth plate becomes inflamed and painful. Sever's disease is extremely common. It is the most common cause of heel pain in growing children, especially those who play sports or exercise regularly. It normally develops in kids aged 8 to 14, and is present for approximately 3 to 4 years. Boys are affected more often than are girls. The condition is bilateral in up to 2/3 of cases. Factors that can lead to this injury are participation in sports or other activities that involve running or jumping, abnormal heel striking that can result in repetitive microtrauma to the area, and excessive traction placed on the area by the Achilles tendon. The following conditions may increase your child's chances of contracting Sever's disease: wearing footwear that lacks heel cushioning or support, such as flip-flops, or athletic shoes with heel cleats, particularly soccer cleats, which center the force of impact on the heel. High or flat arches, which can affect the heel's angle within the foot. A tight Achilles tendon, when one leg is shorter than the other one. Being overweight or suffering from obesity. Symptoms. For children with Sever's disease, the most common symptom is pain in the back of the heel. The pain can cause children to walk on their toes or walk with a limp. In some cases, both heels have symptoms, although one heel may be worse than the other. The pain worsens during high-impact sports and activities that put pressure on a growth plate in the heel, and improves with rest. Diagnosis. Your child's doctor will gather information about your child's symptoms. The characteristic history is one of chronic heel pain that is related to activity and has an insidious onset. The diagnosis of Sever's disease is made clinically. The doctor will apply gentle pressure to the heel and foot to determine which specific areas are causing the pain. The physical examination demonstrates heel pain tenderness during direct palpation over the apophysis. Pain with the calcaneal compression test suggests the presence of Sever disease. With the patient supine, the examiner compresses the calcaneus from the medial and lateral side. Radiographs are not required to make the diagnosis, but should be obtained to exclude other disorders if the presentation is atypical, for example, inability to bear weight, acute onset, or associated constitutional symptoms. Or if the patient fails to make appropriate clinical progress with routine management in 4 to 8 weeks. The X-ray findings of Sever's disease look similar to those in normal children without symptoms. MRI is appropriate in patients with normal plain radiographs who have severe symptoms, or do not respond to routine management after 4 to 8 weeks. Treatment. The best treatment is simply rest. The doctor will usually direct the child to cut back on all activities and sports until the swelling goes down and the pain is gone, with a gradual increase once symptoms have subsided. Applying ice to the area for 20 minutes. Apply ice packs to the heel a few times a day for 4 or 5 days. Not directly on the skin. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, can relieve pain and swelling. It is important to ensure that children's shoes fit well and provide adequate cushioning and support to minimize the risk of aggravating this condition. Heel cushions inserted in shoes can help absorb impact and relieve stress on the heel and ankle. Physical therapy is also often employed at this time to help the patient improve calf flexibility and strength. The therapist will set up specific exercises, like stretching, to help improve symptoms. In cases where the pain is bad enough to interfere with walking, a walker boot might be required to immobilize the foot while it heals. In severe cases, your child may need a cast so their heel is forced to rest. There is no role for operative treatment. Symptoms typically go away after a few months. For the compliant patient whose symptoms fail to improve within 4 to 8 weeks, we have to exclude other causes of heel pain. The good news is that the condition doesn't cause any long-term foot problems. Sever's disease can last until your child is fully grown. Once the growth plates close, the condition resolves itself.